Good morning, all of you. Welcome to Sri Sai Vidya School. My name is Karthik Kumar and I am dealing the subject Chemistry IIT. Today's session is for class 8. In module 2, the chapter name is GOC, General Organic Chemistry. Now, what is the main topic here? Nomenclature of organic compounds. In the previous class, we have discussed that the basic structure of nomenclature of organic compound. What is the basic structure here? It may contain totally 3 parts. What are the 3 parts here? Prefix, word root, as well as suffix. And in the classification also, in the previous class we discussed that primary prefix again may classified into prefix and suffix. That both are again may classified into primary and secondary. Word root, another name, root word. Now coming to suffix here, suffix may classified into two types again here, primary suffix. Now here, secondary suffix. While coming to the priority order here, structure. First of all, secondary prefix plus, after that, primary prefix plus word root plus primary suffix plus secondary suffix. What about the secondary prefix and the primary prefix? Can we discuss earlier in the earlier class? Now coming to the topic here. Root word. Root word another name, word root. Root word another name, word root. What about the definition of a root word? It tells about the number of carbon atoms that contain a functional group, multiple bonding, substituent in the main skeleton at minimum position in the decreasing order of the priority. Now coming to root word, it gives the information of number of carbon atoms. Number of carbon atoms. Okay, the number of carbon atoms that from 1 to 4 given are named by common, based upon common names. And 5 onwards named by Greek or Greek names. Now, if the number of carbon atoms are 1, then it is considered as the root word myth. Number of carbon atoms are 2, it is ith. If it is 3, the root word is pro. C4 represents here but. C5 represents pent. Pent represents the from a Greek symbol. Now coming to carbon atom 6. C6 represents here hex. C7 represents here hepta. Now there is a small chance to confuse here. C7 sometimes in common name we can use the septet, but according to IUPAC nomenclature, okay, for representation of 7 carbon atoms, just we will use the heptet. Hept is correct while the sept is wrong. Now coming to C8. C8 represents here oct. C9 root word is none. C10 root word is deck. In the same way, the number of carbon atoms are 11, then it is represented by ande. C12 dode. C13 tride. C14 tetrade. C15 Pentad A, C16, Hexad A, C17, Heptad A, C18, Octad A, C19, Nond A. Up to C19 we can write as it is. Now C20, it can have the root word ecos. C30, triacont. C40, tetragon. C50, pentagon. C60, hexagon. C70, heptagon. C80, octagon. C90, nonagon. C100 represents your hect. C100 represents your hect. Now, in the primary structure, after the discussion about the root word, then immediately we will attend to the suffix. Then, what about suffix here? Suffix again I classified basically into two types. What are they? Primary suffix. And now here, secondary suffix. Now coming to the discussion of primary suffix. It gives the information of given organic compound, whether it is saturated or unsaturated. If it is saturated, then the primary suffix is an. If it is unsaturated, the primary suffix, if it contains double bond, then it is ene. If the main chain of the carbon, given organic compound, that contains triple bond, then suffix is ine. Now coming to the type of carbon atom. Type of carbon atom. Primary suffix and the generic name or general name. Now if it contains two double bonds, first of all here if it contains only single bond carbon, primary suffix is A. Generic name is alkene. Now C double bond carbon, primary suffix is ene, then a generic name is alkene. Carbon and carbon may contain triple bond, its shape will be linear shape according to Weber theory. Now primary suffix is ene and the general name is alkyne. Now removing of hydrogen atom from alkene, minus one hydrogen atom, then it represents alkyl. Yl is the primary suffix and the generic name is alkyl. Similarly, in the same way, from ene to removing one hydrogen atom, enyl, generic name is alkenyl. Now removing of hydrogen atom from alkyne, it represents enyl, generic name is alkyneyl. Okay, this is a brief discussion about the type of carbon atom, the classification of primary suffix along with its generic name. In the given structure, if it contains two double bonds, same combination type of carbonate, two double bonds hence primary suffix is diene, two double bonds primary suffix is diene. Okay, here there is option double small e at the end of the primary suffix. Small e represents there is no functional group and it is only an example of hydrocarbon. Now generic name is alkadiene. Now if it contain three double bonds then a primary suffix is triene and the generic name is alkatriene and here it may contain e at the end of the generic name. The represents it is only hydrocarbon. Now if it contain n double bonds n represents the number of carbon atom, that is nothing but here root word. Now coming to primary suffix polyene. Now in case of polyene, now we can write here alka polyene generic name. Now if it contain two triple bonds then the primary suffix is diene. Now here alka diene. Now last one here, that is if it contain three triple bonds. Now here it may contain the primary suffix, that is triene. What is the generic name here? Alka triene. Now similarly the triple bonds may contain n triple bonds also can represent polyene. Now in this session we have discussed that word root and primary suffix. Word root from C1 to C100. It is not the end of the carbon atoms, organic compounds that are uncountable. We can able to give the nomenclature for each and every organic compound by following the IUPAC rules. We can able to give the nomenclature of the given organic compounds. Now primary suffix, about the primary suffix also we given that brief discussion here. Now in the previous class we have discussed that secondary suffix, the type of functional group. Secondary suffix